Let's start with what the big issues are in the Central Valley there, in your district. Is immigration at the top of the list?
Immigration is huge. Immigration, health care, and jobs are really the big three issues that we're campaigning on. 50% of my district is on Medicaid, which means that our congressman's vote a year and a half ago, May 4th, 2017, would have kicked 100,000 residents off of access to health insurance. And so there's a lot of folks who are frustrated by that vote who are looking to make a change here in the next 20 days.
Do those people vote?
They do. 50% of an entire district on Medicaid is big. It's the reason I'm running. My younger brother David was born 10 weeks premature, spent the first 2 years of his life in and out of a hospital. When I saw he would have been kicked off insurance till he's 65 and on Medicare, I decided to run. Many people in my district have a loved one in the same situation, and that's why we're trying to get this campaign over the finish line.
What does your opponent say on this issue? Does the opponent agree with you on this?
He's proud of his vote, he says in our debate just a couple weeks ago. I think he doesn't think the government should actually have a role in health insurance. I think in a district like this one, where everyone has a daughter with diabetes, an uncle who has cancer, a loved one who would have been affected, one of those 23 million Americans who would have been kicked off access to care, this is a personal issue for so many Americans, and that's why this election is so important.
So health care is an issue that's important to your district and also distinguishes you from your opponent. Talk about immigration. The President of the United States has just tweeted out recently, Republicans must make the horrendous, weak, and outdated immigration laws and the border a part of the midterms. He wants it to be an issue. If it's an issue, how does it cut for in your district?
I love for this election to be a referendum on the failures on immigration in the last 2 years. The economic district of what I represent is based on immigration. That's the heart and soul of our entire community. There's a young woman on my campaign working two part-time jobs, a student at the local community college who's a dreamer, who would have been kicked out of this country because of the failures of the last 2 years. I think people in our district want to make sure that we're reuniting families separated at the borders, that we're protecting these 2 million kids, these dreamers across America, many of whom live in my district, over 10,000 living in my district, and making sure that we're creating a path where every immigrant in America can have access to the same things that everybody else does. That means that we actually got to make sure we're putting people in Congress who can pass an immigration reform bill, because clearly we're not seeing that with the Congress we have today.
So another issue that's clearly important to people in your district, but on this one, is there clear daylight between you and your opponent? Doesn't he agree there should be reform as well?
Look, he's released a lot of press releases. He's said a lot. The fact is, we have a federal government run by Republicans. They run the House, they run the Senate, they run the presidency. If they wanted to get something done on immigration, they have all the power. They could do it. And clearly, they haven't. In fact, over the last 2 years, our immigration problem has gotten a lot worse. That means that the only way that we create progress on this issue has got to be at the ballot box. It's got to be replacing people who say one thing in the district and then go back to Washington and vote with their party 98% of the time, like my opponent, and replacing them with people who are going to fight for the constituents that actually need progress on immigration so desperately.
So, Josh, finally, maybe intangible, but how do you fit with that district? I know that your family goes back several generations in the Central Valley. At the same time, some people say that you really are more of a Bay Area guy, that you really are no longer attached to the Central Valley. So when you go out and make your pitch, how do you say I belong as your representative?
Yeah, my family's been in this district for five generations. I think I got the best of the Central Valley. My community invested very deeply in me. My first job was a paperboy for the Turlock Journal at age 12, went through the public school system. I'm running because most kids in my district do not have access to the same opportunities that I did. 80% of our kids on free or reduced lunch in our school districts. And so on all the issues that I care about, healthcare, immigration, jobs, this disastrous trade war, we need somebody who's going to fight for us, not fight for one party or another. And we have somebody in this district today who's fighting with his party, voting with his party 98% of the time. And that's why we need a change.